Hey guys, I just wanted to come to you today with a really serious topic, something that I think is plaguing the games industry, and I'm hoping that together we can institute some kind of change. Now, I've got a change.org petition started right now. It's called Gamers Against Continuing Free Support for Months-Old Games. We just won't stand it anymore. I think I speak for all of us when I say this, because how often do you buy a game, you play it, you say, you know, I've got my fill of that game. It's time for me to move on to one of the many other hundreds of games in my Steam library. Give them some attention and love. But then Psyonix comes along with Rocket League, selfishly trying and vying for your exclusive attention, trying to keep you coming back again and again, long past its expiration date, long past its time in the spotlight. It wants more. A little greedy, some would say. Some would indeed say it's time to pour Rocket League out like so much spoiled milk that's been sitting in the refrigerator for so long it has begun to solidify to the plastic carton that you first bought it in, that when you turn it upside down unscrewed, it won't pour out. It merely oozes. It slithers and slides little by little until finally you resign to your fate. You look at it. You look at that brand new hockey puck in Rocket League that's replaced the soccer ball that looks like a gigantic Oreo, and you decide milk's favorite cookie deserves some milk. So you dip that hockey puck in the milk and you eat it with a stoic expression on your face, but one that is ultimately satisfied. You just pretend not to like it so that your friends and family don't think less of you. But I urge you not to think any less of me, nor will I of you. This is just one game mode, so it's not like the hockey puck is replacing the ball in the whole game. But so many thousands of people are playing this game mode, it's gotta go somewhere. I've seen 8,000 to 10,000 concurrent queuing for this all simultaneously, which is insane to me. I would love to see just a few tweaks made to make this a real proper permanent game mode, because right now I guess it's just a temporary, perhaps once a year deal. So it is kind of limited time only, unless enough people speak out about it. What makes the hockey puck so different is it's so heavy. It's really big disc, so it's hard to miss, but at the same time, it's so thin that occasionally you'll find yourself driving right underneath it or right to the side if the puck happens to be standing upright, which it often does, setting up for perhaps a nice kickoff. But it changes the whole dynamic of how it rides along the wall and how the goal posts interact with the weird shape, because with a ball you can very much predict where it's going to hit, where it's going to bounce off, but it's a lot harder this way. You get some weird kicks into the goal that elevate it above other cars that they're not expecting it, or more commonly you'll sit at midfield, hit a return over the wall where it slides along the corner, bounces off the enemy post, and kind of throws itself into the goal without any outside help. It's got some really crazy fun new types of ways to score. The only thing that I think needs to be tweaked are the positionings of the goal. Right now, there's way too much emphasis on kind of riding the wall and just hitting it along the wall towards the goal. Everyone's kind of figured that out and will counter by riding up the wall to stop the puck from getting in front of the goal. It's fun for a little while, but indeed it does get a little bit old. So some people have suggested perhaps moving the goal forward so that it's out from the wall, or making the map bigger so that there is space behind the goal. I think that would slow the game down too much and perhaps only make it one or two goal games. Right now, it's still very easy to score 3 to 5 points in a single round of this. So in that sense, it's a lot more exciting because they're generally very high scoring games. So I don't want to make that any harder to accomplish. So what I would suggest, just in the short term, pretty easy to fix, is making a lip around the goalposts so that any hockey puck that is coming down off the wall over the goal, instead of kind of scoring itself, which is what happens half the time now, it kind of deflects back onto the field and allows for plays to be made. I think that sounds a little bit more exciting to me. I like the idea of passing. There's a lot more control over the puck this way than the ball, because the ball's bouncing around, it's very light and fluffy, you hit it and it flies forward. The puck you can actually catch up to and maneuver a lot easier. I'd say it's more noob-friendly for dribbling. You can get into the hockey puck and figure out how to dribble it instantly, because the ball's not going to bounce away from you in this instance. So I have not practiced really dribbling the regular ball myself, so I'm pretty bad at it still. And this is a little bit more refreshing because it feels like you have more control. Now, if there was some way that you could use some power-up or something, maybe use 100% of your boost to do some kind of slap shot on the puck and shoot it even faster, that would be really fun too. I'd love to see a whole game devoted around this, where it's more focused on passing rather than just optimal position against the ball. I don't know if that makes any sense. But anyways, guys, I wanted to take another look into Rocket League. I love these free updates. Of course, I should not fail to mention that just by playing, you can unlock new toppers and antennas and even a new trail, all free of charge. So I think it's awesome that this DLC continues to come out. Thank you for making me drink the spoiled milk and your Oreos, Psyonix. And thank you guys so much for watching this video. Let me know what you think of the update down in the comments below. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.